What's up, guys? This is Brian with WT Vapes, or White Trash Vapes. Whatever you want to call it, is what it is. WT is short for White Trash Vapes. Today, we're coming to you with the Recoil RDA by Grim Green and Homeboy OC. But before we go any farther, just make sure and go to CASA.org, August8th.org. Do your calls to action. Try to do your best to contact your representatives. Send them emails, phone calls. Send them handwritten letters. Don't type it up on your computer, handwrite it, whatever you want to do. CASA's got this thing where you can find out what representatives represent your state and all that. Send them your story and all that. CASA's got a thing on their website where it's pretty easy. Pretty much all you have to do is put in your zip code and the state you live in, and they got everything written up for you. You can just add your story to the email and send it to them. Just, we need to do everything we can. And like, whenever you're at work, talk to people that might smoke or might vape, or even people that don't smoke and don't vape and don't know about the stuff that's going on with the FDA regulations. Just let them know. Just spread awareness. That's what we need right now, is to spread awareness. That's the biggest thing right now, I think. Of course, support the Right to Be Smoke Free lawsuit and the Nick and Pure lawsuit and all that, and support that. And you can send 50 cents to them, $1 to them, whatever, $5, $10, hell, if you're so inclined and you can do $100,000, good job. Keep doing it, do it. But with that being said, we'll be looking at the Recoil RDA by Grim Green, Homeboy OC. We'll go down, take some measurements of it, see what comes in the packaging, all that, and then we'll come back up, talk about it, see what I think about it, and yeah, that'll pretty much be it. Might have a drink or two, who knows. Might be a little bit of vodka mixed in there, but there is, it's okay. You can have one too. Have one and a vape. Fine. So with that being said, we'll go down, take some measurements of it, see how tall it is, what the diameter is, da da da. See what comes in the packaging. So that being said, I'll see y'all down there. Here we are with the Recoil RDA. We'll go through the packaging. It says Recoil on the front, on the top of the packaging, and it's got Grim Green's logo, Homeboy OC's logo. Nothing. Same thing, Homeboy OC and Grim Green. Nothing. It's got some cool Recoil logos on the back. Like how they made the notch cutouts on both sides so it's easy to open. We'll open it upside down. We'll open it. And we have the RDA. Have the Recoil RDA sitting right here. And then we have an extra sleeve for it, which this one is the 3mm. It has 2 3mm holes on that side, 2 3mm holes on that side for your airflow. Then this one that I have on there right now is 2 2.5mm airflow holes on each side. So this one is a little less air, a little bit more for flavor, and this one's a little more for clouds, I guess, if you wanted to say a little more airflow. Personally, I use the 2.5mm air holes sleeve just because that's the way I like it. And down here, I have a little baggie of extra O-rings, 4 extra post screws, pretty good bit of extras. I mean, extra O-rings for every bit of it. I mean, for your bait, for the extra O-rings for the build deck, little extra O-rings for up here at the drip tip, and a couple extra O-rings, I guess, for your little top cap, chuff cap, whatever you want to call it. But, and also, the resistance on this is pretty good. I find it really, really good, honestly. And the drip tip, it's not your normal standard 510 drip tip. It's just a wide bore drip tip that slides over these. It has two O-rings there, which is self-explanatory. It just slides over that. So now we'll get some measurements on it. Turn on my set of caliper, digital calipers here. Zero it out. And get a reading on the inside of the drip tip is 11.9. Then zero it out. Outside of the drip tip is, say, 15. We'll move down to about where the base of it is. Say 24, 23.98, I'm gonna say 24. And push this drip tip all the way down on there. She's all the way down on there. Get them reading from the bottom of it to the top of the drip tip, which will be, she's 33.5 millimeters tall. Not bad. So, throw on my little field stand here. If I can get it on there. Sorry, guys. Now these O-rings here for the actual airflow sleeve, or however you want to, whatever you want to call it, is tight. It is really, really tight. So you don't have to worry about it coming off or anything. I'll show you that here in a little bit. But see the size of the build deck. You're right there. We'll give them 20.3 millimeters, the size of the build deck, which, it's not too bad. Honestly, I kind of expected a little more, being what it is. I mean, I expected a little more. Let's see the size of these holes are. 2.1, I figured they'd be a little bigger. Yeah, 2.2. I figured they'd at least be 2.5 to 2.3. Maybe I'm measuring it wrong, but it's coming up to 2.25. I figured it was about 2.5, almost 3, but, well, that's my measurings, so. That said, we got some flathead grub screws, nice flathead grub screws, and as you can see, the positive block is lower than the positive post holes, so pretty much it's a three post, and then the center post is more or less a block with two holes in it, as you can see for the positive, and it's lower that way because coils, obviously, as I'll show you here, you have one lead high, on top, one lead coming off the bottom, so it does make it easy to install them. So that said, we'll throw some coils in here. One thing I kind of hate about flatheads. They're hard, flatheads are hard to strip, but it's easy for your flathead screwdriver to slide out of the flathead. But we'll see if we can't manage here. Get this all under control. And I don't have the steadiest hands in the world, so that could be to that. So, but we'll get through it. We'll manage. Hopefully we'll make it through this video without chopping off my finger. I think I'm trying to put too much pressure here. There she is. We'll throw some coils in here, and these are 2.5 millimeter inner diameter. They are staggered fuse Claptons. I can get this camera to focus, but probably won't. But they are staggered fuse Claptons, 28 gauge, dual 28 gauge in the center, with which are staggered Clapton with 36 gauge, and then they are fused together with 38 gauge. 28 gauge is 316L, and the 34 and 36 gauge is stainless steel 304. So, and I did make them myself. You can see they're not perfect, but they'll work. I believe they will work. So, anyways, we're going to stick them in there. All I'm going to do is stick them all the way in there. Get them up as close and tight as some posts as I to the post that I can. And we'll tighten the grub screws down. Alright, I hit the camera and shook the camera. Now, all I'm gonna do, kind of push that coil over to the center and out. Just like that. And snip these leads off. Just like finger over it. And get it to fall off my finger. So that's one. Now for the fun, getting this one to come through. I have to bend that center leg up a little bit, that way she'll pass over that other coil, I hope. I'm butchering this crab right now. Kind of had to bend your leads on that middle coil like that. That way, whenever you put it in, it automatically goes on top of the other coil. That's One thing I have noticed that's kind of aggravating with this build deck . Tighten these grub screws down. One thing I like about this build deck is flathead screws, so it's hard to strip out, but flatheads are always easy to slit the screwdriver out of, so, but they're hard to strip, so that is one good thing. Torque down a little bit. Now we'll just do like we've done the other one. Push her over and pull out. Just like that. Looks alright. Bend this lead down. Get a hold of it. Put your finger over it so it don't fly off. Get in somebody's foot or one of your kids' feet. This one's a little aggravating to get to. But we got it. So now, stick her tool back in there, pull up and out. Looks pretty good to me. And this one. Up and out. That looks pretty close to me. So, take her off. I don't drop it everywhere. Throw on the trusty old RX200. Set the wattage for and 25 watts. Or get our ceramic tweezers because we might need them. Oh, hang on. Come on out. Yeah. I'm a little happier with that. Yeah. They're actually heating pretty even. Take a simple squeeze there. Squeeze there. Turn up just a little more, about 35 watts. Oh yeah, that'll work. That'll get us through the video anyways. Now, take some cotton bacon while that's cooling down. Wick her up. That's back here. Pull her on through like that and pull her back. I'll pull it back and forth a little bit. And this thing does have pretty good juice well in it, so what I'm gonna do, come out to about right there, snipper, and right there. Up and close and unboxing of the recoil. So what I think about it, I mean, honestly, it puts off a really good vape. I mean, personally me, I like the, man, I can't even think right now. I like the sleeve that has the two 2.5 millimeter airflow holes in it. The one with the little bit tighter draw, I like that. A lot of people, I'm sure, like the sleeve that has the 3 millimeter air hole. I'm sure if you like more airflow, I'm sure you'll like that. But personally, me, I like the 2.5 millimeter air holes because it just puts off a nice kind of restrictive lung hit for me and gives me a really good flavor, especially with, like you've seen, I put some staggered fused Claptons in here. Puts off some really good flavor. Even with what I really like to vape in this is round wired them stainless steel 316 24 gauge, about 8 wraps. Slap them in there, throw some cotton in there, and it provides really good flavor and really good vapor production. Kind of expected a little bit bigger of a build deck. Being what it is, kind of expected the build room, a little more room to build in, but it's respectable. I can throw some pretty decent builds in there. I see staggered fused Claptons. I've had fused Claptons in here. I just expected a little more room, but it's a really nice vape. Really, really, really nice vape. As far as cons with it, I don't think they had to make the drip tip on this. They did not have to make that damn thing. They did not have to make it so fucking tight, but it's a good thing because, you can just grab the drip tip. You can just grab the drip tip and without the drip tip coming off, you can actually pull the top cap off, dump your liquid down in there, and keep on vaping. So it's not really a con because I can get it off, but I can see some people griping about it because it is a pain to get off. Other than that, the size of the drip tip's a comfortable size. I really like it. Really, really like it. It provides a really good vape. 55 watts, 3.2 volts at 1.9 ohms with a dual staggered fuse Clapton in there. I mean, it provides a wonderful vape. That's really all I got to say about it. I mean, I like it. The machine quality's great. There was no burrs on it. Came in the package clean. I mean, I gave it a good washing, of course. I try to do with everything I get in. I mean, I don't get a lot of products in because I buy all the products I get with my own hard-earned money that I go to work and work a normal job for. I mean, so I don't get a whole lot of products, but whenever I do, I wash them and vape them. I mean, that's just what I do. But I mean, it's got really, really good build quality. Machining on it's really well. It didn't have no burrs on it, no nicks on it. Very clean. It's a really nice looking RDA. I really like the way it looks on the eFusion Duo, and that's what I should have had it on for this review, but I didn't. So it is what it is, but I really love this. Really do. I've been using it. I got it about 2 weeks ago. I got it, and I've been using it, I mean, not all day, every day, because I got the Goon, and I got the K-Fun V5, and Griffin 25, and da-da-da, and I kind of switch back and forth, but this has been, it's been in the lineup. I mean, I've used it every day. I'm not going to say I've used it every day, all day, but I have used it almost every day since I bought it. The cap's tight on it, so it I don't have no leaking on. I mean, not unless I slam it damn full with juice, of course it'll leak then, yeah. But as far as just leaking around the bottom of it where it goes together at and stuff, I don't have no leaking with that because the O-rings fit tight. They really do. Fit real tight. Just provides a good vape though. But with that being said, I'm Brian with WT Vapes on YouTube. My email is WTV.whitetrashvapes@gmail.com. If you want, send me an email, leave your comments below. Don't forget to like, subscribe, give me a thumbs down, whatever you want to do. I mean, whatever. Whatever makes me happy, leave the comments below, contact me, whatever. I'm just a normal guy putting my opinions out there. So, that being said, I'm out here, guys. Later.